The T-62 medium tank is one of the most produced Soviet armored vehicles ever. It was developed because the Soviets wanted an improved version of the T-55. That's pretty common knowledge. But what's interesting is how it ended up with a 115mm smoothbore gun, because that gun wasn't something they had mass produced before. So what led to this decision, and why did they go for such an unusual caliber? That's exactly what we're gonna talk about in today's video. So hello and welcome and enjoy this video. To answer this question, we have to go back to the 1950s.
We're going back in time.
At that time, the Soviets realized that the 100mm D-10T gun used in the T-54 and 55 was getting outdated. The gun was first made in 1944, and while it was pretty strong back then, technology had advanced a lot in these 10 years, so they had to move on to something new. In 1951, the Kharkov No. 75 Design Bureau, led by Alexander Morozov, one of the OG designers of the T-34, T-44 and T-54 tanks, was tasked with creating a completely new tank. To improve the tank's firepower, the OKB-9 Design Bureau began work on a new 100mm rifled gun, the D-54. However, the development of this gun quickly became the most challenging aspect of the entire project. By 1953, Morozov presented the first design for the new tank, which was supposed to have this gun and was called Object 430. This is an image of an Object 430 with a D-54 TS gun. One of the initial upgrade ideas was to equip a T-54M tank with the D-54 gun and an experimental stabilizer called Raduga. This upgrade was known as Object 139. Although the goal was to boost the firepower of the widely produced T-54 easily, the Raduga stabilizer proved unreliable during tests in 1955, preventing it from entering production. This setback led to a new stabilizer called Molniya, which showed much better results. By late 1955, three prototypes were completed, and the D-54 gun with this new stabilizer was called the D-54 TS, just like with this Object 430 you've already seen before. In 1954, Kartsev, the guy from the UVZ plant, took a big risk by suggesting that another tank, the Object 140, should be equipped with the D-54 gun. This image here shows the Object 140. Even though there was no direct demand from the military or government, Kartsev pushed forward, and by 1957, three prototypes of Object 140 and one of Object 430 were ready, all equipped with D-54 TS guns. However, further issues with the Molniya stabilizer led to a switch to a new system called Metel. Meanwhile, another significant factor in Soviet tank development was the British Royal Ordnance 105mm L7 gun. Reports indicated that this powerful gun could easily penetrate Soviet tanks. When the Americans started making their own version of the L7 in 1960, called the M68, the Soviets went into panic mode and started full-scale developments to counter it. Responding to this threat, Kartsev's team at UVZ led the charge in developing a new tank. This new tank design was called Object 165, and here you can see an image of it. Their new design used a lot from the T-55, but was longer and wider with a bigger turret ring. They also used the Object 140 turret and the D-54 TS gun. The factory and military tests for this tank went pretty smoothly, since it mostly used parts and designs that were already mass-produced. Eventually, the gun was given the factory name U-8TS and officially entered Soviet service on August 12, 1961 under the name of T-62A. So now, with all this context, how did the 115mm gun actually end up in the T-62? To finally get to the answer, we need to go back to the fall of 1958. At that time, the OKB-9 Design Bureau created the 100mm T-12 Rapira anti-tank gun. This was a powerful weapon that could fire effective heat rounds. Unfortunately, when the gun was shown to Nikita Khrushchev, he became very eager to equip tanks with this exact weapon. To make matters even worse, some retard told him it could be done quickly, which made Khrushchev even more excited. Witnesses even heard him say, "Great, let's build 200 tanks with this gun next year." Fact is, this was pretty much impossible.
Extinction rebellion! Yeah, I'll show you an extinction.
When Kartsev was called to Moscow and tasked with putting the T-12 gun into a tank, he immediately said it was impossible. After a full day of friendly but firm pressure, he got desperate and asked to meet with Khrushchev. He wanted to explain to him that the laws of physics could not be bent even for the first secretary of the Central Committee of the Communist Party of the Soviet Union.
When I sit here as the richest person who's ever fucking wasted his time talking to your fucking dumbass and tells you what to do, you don't fucking listen to me.
Just kidding. The task was almost impossible because of the size of the ammunition. The T-12 gun used a round which was 1.2 meters long, which was too big to load inside the crammed tank. But still, the party members insisted that a promise made to the first secretary had to be kept, even if it was unrealistic.
Don't challenge me. You're effectively challenging me to a fight now. You're challenging me to a fight. You're saying I can't hurt you. You're out of your fucking mind?
So they started working on modifying the gun for tank use. As Kartsev expected, the long ammo was a big problem, and they had to shorten it to 1.1 meters, which was still almost too long. Kartsev came up with an emergency solution. To keep the same firepower, they made the ammo shorter but increased its diameter. To do this, they removed the rifling from the gun and turned it into a smoothbore. The OKB-9 design bureau handled this task. There were worries that this might reduce accuracy, but those concerns turned out to be wrong. This modified smoothbore gun was then installed in an Object 165 medium tank, which would later become the T-62A. And the tank was redesignated as Object 166. This image shows an Object 166. Several more prototypes were built in 1966. The changes made to the D-54TS gun increased its caliber from 100mm to 115mm. They also moved the ejector, removed the muzzle brake, and with these adjustments, the U-5TS Molot 115mm smoothbore gun was created. During firing tests, this new gun was a bit less accurate than the older D-10TS, but it had twice the effective range, an excellent muzzle velocity of 1600 meters per second with subcaliber ammo, and great penetration power. This gun was then placed in a new cast turret, which was stronger than the one on the T-55. In the summer of 1961, this new turret was installed on the Object 165 hull. With these upgrades, the tank was accepted into service as the T-62 on the same day as the T-62A, August 12th, 1961. Anyways, that was all I had to say for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you think I said anything that is not right, or you think I should have added any additional information to this video, please let me know in the comments and share your knowledge. Besides that, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video.
Right track damage. Target hit! Target destroyed!